Okay, stop. Don't move. It's a great big one right there.
I told you.
A snake in one hand and a gig in the other. All right, snake, calm down. Question is, did I get him? Like, I got him in the head. Yeah, I did. Got him right in the head.
Told you he was big.
That's a good sized frog. What do you think, snake? Right behind the head. That's a good kill there. What do you think? Think that's a good kill? I think that's a good kill. You want to get let go now? Put you in the water. You take off and go somewhere. All right, so this is where we're at. Got two good sized eaters here. We'll make a mighty fine meal. So what we don't want to do is we don't want to cook on open flame. We want to cook on hot coals best we can. We're going to set this up a little bit special today. Cook some of these frog legs from last night, breaded in a pan and fried. And we're going to cook a couple of catfish fillets, a little different than you may have seen before, using some gear from SRO. Afternoon, folks. I'm Dave Canterbury with Self-Reliance Outfitters and the Pathfinder School. Got a fire going out here so we can cook up some good food here in just a few minutes, but I want to talk to you a little bit about this frog gig that I used last night on the frog hunt. This is a new gig from SRO, and it is part of our monthly special, but it comes with a plastic cover, which I like really well. You could tie a string to that so you wouldn't lose it if you wanted to. It's got five heavy tines on it. This is not the gig that you buy from South Bend or any of those places like Walmart. This thing is heavy duty. And what I do with my gig, all these gigs come with a hole. Can't hardly get it off of there. I've got it on there so seated so well, but all these gigs come with holes drilled through them so that you can put a screw in there if you want to. I forgo that because I don't want to have to mess with screws while I'm out hunting. And I just either cut a notch and tie a string on my pole, or I drill it all the way through if I've got a pole that I'm using dedicated for that. And then I attach a string, a loop, to that gig so that just in case it were to come off of there while I'm hunting with it, I don't lose the gig or the animal that I've stuck. And that just gives me a way to hang on to my equipment a little bit better, gives me a little bit of a safety factor. And again, you wouldn't need to do that if it was a permanent gig that you had drilled and screwed. But if this is something that you're carrying in your kit, and you're going to use it every once in a while and you're carving a stick in the woods, it's easy enough just to cut a seven notch in that stick, put a lashing in there and tie it to that hole and then push it down on there so there's no chance of losing that gear in deeper water. All right, so first of all, I'm a huge fan of this just add water stuff. This is a Bisquick just add water cheese garlic. And this, combined with some seasoning, is what we're going to use to bread our fish and our frog legs in. I'm just going to use a Ziploc bag, and I can use this to store this in after the fact if I want to for a couple days. And we're gonna rip this open maybe. It may take a knife to get the job done, which is okay too. And then we're just gonna pour, I don't know, half of it probably in this Ziploc bag, and we're gonna use this for our breading bag, just like that. And now we're gonna add some seasoning to this bag as well. Okay, I've got a bottle of this Grill Mate roasted garlic seasoning. Chicken, fish, that's what this is really good for. And I'm going to actually pour some of this in, put a pretty good amount in there. And then I'm gonna shake this up really good to mix it into the into that dough. What I'm really looking for consistency-wise is I wanna be able to see those seasonings in that batter. If I didn't put enough in there that I can't see it when I mix it up, then I'm gonna put a little bit more in there. Okay, so the next step in the puzzle is, we have went ahead and thrown our catfish fillet in our seasoning bag and got it all coated really good with seasoning. And I've left it in there for 3 or 4 minutes to absorb some of that and really shook it around really, really good. Now, taking two sticks, first I pounded two forks in the ground, and those two sticks are gonna lay like this. And I'm going to entrap this fillet between two of our cook grates, which are gonna come in that monthly special. So I'm going to pull this fillet out and lay it on top of one of these, just like this. Seal that bag up. We'll use that for the frog legs here in a few minutes. Lay that fillet out nice and flat. And we're going to put the other one right on top of it, just like this, to trap it in there. So now we've got our fillet trapped in between. We've got two sticks cut that we've put slits in. And I'm going to open that slit up with my knife a little bit here, just like this. And I'm going to put a small stick in there just to kind of keep that open for a minute, just like that. Just enough to be able to get it on top of this rack, like this, and encompass both of those. Push that fillet in there just a little bit. Push that down on top of it, just like this, and then the stick should come out like that. And then we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Now we can rotate our fish to cook it evenly. Flames get a little high, we can turn it sideways, either direction. And we can rotate it 360 degrees above the hot bed of coals and adjust the fire as we need to get it cooked evenly. And then we'll cook our legs on this fire once the flames are completely gone. We can put our skillet on the coals. All right, so we're gonna warm up our olive oil in our skillet here. Kind of off to the side. Rotate our fillet. Keep that thing cooking good. We can rotate that any direction we want to with this setup. It works really, really good. I went ahead and deboned these frog legs, just cut the meat off the bone, make it easier to fry up and look a little more presentable in the skillet. Got the legs and claws on there. Okay, so real quick, let's talk about this Surf and Turf monthly special. You're gonna get a pocket fishing kit. You're gonna get a 5-tine frog gig with the plastic cover. You're going to get a Pathfinder skillet with the lid. And you're going to get two of these racks, these large rectangular racks that I'm using to cook this fish fillet on right now. That can be used in many, many different combinations for cooking around camp. This is a perfect combination for cooking fish, frogs, small game, and things like that around your camp. And I'm pretty excited about it. The retail price of this kit is a huge percentage off the MSRP. $39.95 for the complete kit. Fishing kit, frog gig, two grates, Pathfinder skillet with lid, $39.95 this month at SelfRelianceOutfitters.com. Let's get over here and get one of these frog legs, see what we got going on here. Oh man, got some really good white meat right there. There's a bone right there, maybe I missed. Oh man, fantastic. Well, I think our fillet is pretty close to being done.
All right, should be where we need to be here. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a skillet and set this rack right on top of the skillet, just like that. Peel that off. We're probably gonna stick to the rack a little bit, I would say, but that's okay. Get a little bit of remnant sticking to the rack. You can eat that right off of there. Nothing to it. Oh yeah. Makes for good camp picking. Oh man. That's freaking good. Holy cow. The main part's right here. Look at that, holy cow. Oh man. Not good. All right
guys, well, I'm Dave Canterbury with Self-Reliance Outfitters and the Pathfinder School. I appreciate you guys joining me out here today at camp for just a quick surf and turf type lunch, some frog legs and some catfish. Appreciate your views. I appreciate your support. I thank you for everything you do for our school, for our family, and for our business, for all of our sponsors, instructors, affiliates, and friends, and I'll be back with another video as soon as I can. Thanks, guys.